Good morning, YouTube. So I finally decided to replace my old ammeter that I had monitoring the current going into my AC power inverter. So I picked up one of these Peacefare PZEM. I think this is a 021 model. It's the DC 0 to 100 amp meter. And I've got that now picking up the current and voltage going into the power inverter. So this morning, 15.55 volts, just short of 12 amps, 185 watts going into the inverter. And let's take a look at that down here. Yeah, so we've got the inverter working here, much quieter than it was before. So there's not the really high pitched buzzing sound that was coming out when the capacitors were in the process of failing. So the reason I have the cover off is I've found another problem in here, and I'm not sure if it's a symptom of the capacitors failing or if it was the cause of the capacitors failing. You might notice that fan right there is not running. For some reason, it seems like the fan controller in here quit working. And like I say, I'm not sure if it failed when the capacitors failed, or if the fan controller failed and that caused the capacitors to overheat and fail. So we can get that in there. If we're down here, we've got about 30C on the heat sinks down there. And if I'm on the transformer here, actually the transformer is about the hottest thing. I've got about 37C. The voltage regulator down there, right by the small inductor, that's probably one of the hottest things. It gets up to, yeah, it's about 40 degrees C. So that little 5 volt, I think it's a 5 volt regulator for the logic board, gets probably the hottest. So I'm gonna forget about using the non-working fan controller on the board, and I'm just gonna unplug the fan. And what I'm going to do is, on top of the case here, I'm going to mount a little circuit board, and I'm going to put a fan controller on top there. And I've got a proportional temperature controlled fan controller coming that I'll replace that. So there'll be a little circuit board on top here. I'll drill a small hole in the top to run cables in and out. So it'll be set up kind of like the control panel there, which connects to the circuit board with a cable. So I'm going to bring 12 volts ground, the fan cable. I'll add my own temperature sensor onto the heat sink over there. Just use one of the extra screw holes. The controller has basically a low and a high temperature set point. So the low set point is where the fan starts running, and then the high set point is where it ramps up to 100%. So that way you can keep the fan running at some speed proportional to the temperature. So you could set it to come on at 30 degrees C at 10% speed, and then ramp up to 100% speed at, say, 40 or 50 degrees C. The controller that's in here seems to only be on-off, and this is about a 1-amp fan. It pulls quite a bit of current, so when the fan was running at full speed, it would really cool the thing down. But I think the fan control circuitry down here was based more on current sensing than on temperature, because it would turn on immediately when you turned on a high current load, and there seemed to be a threshold. Like if you got above 15 amps of DC current, it would turn the fan on, but if you were below that, it would leave it off, and this thing would start getting hot. So that's one thing I'm going to do. The other thing is I want to add a remote on-off for the inverter that I can control with the SBMS120. So I want to be able to have the SBMS120 turn this thing on and off with just basically a contact closure. Right now, you can't do that because it's a soft power button, and you have to hold the button in for maybe 5 seconds to turn it off, hold it in for 5 seconds to turn it on. So what I'm going to be doing is picking up those switch contacts for the on-off switch, and then that yellow LED there that says on, I'm going to pick up the voltage off of that. And then on my little circuit board right here, so I'll probably set up something like an Arduino Pro Mini here and a relay, and I'll have the relay contacts across the switch contact, and then I'm going to monitor the status of that on-off LED, and then have the on-off contact or switch input from the SBMS120. And then just do the logic. If the SBMS tells me to turn this off and it's already off, I don't do anything. Because the problem is it's the same switch turns this thing on and off. You can't just push the switch. You need to know if the unit is running or not. That's my idea, is I want to add that remote on-off circuitry. So this little circuit board here will kind of do double duty. It'll be my fan controller, and it will also handle remote on off. I would have used the remote control input here, but that's an RS-485 signal, and it's kind of a proprietary connector. It's got LEDs plus RS-485 transmit and receive data, so it's kind of a non-standard interface, and I don't know what protocol they're using. So instead, this control board that's on here is totally passive. It's just LEDs and resistors, and then there's switches. So I should be able to pick up all I need right there. I'll pick up the on-off status. I'll pick up the two contacts or two terminals of that switch contact. Do a little bit of kind of reverse engineering there to figure out what pins I need to grab. I'll be able to plug the SBMS120, which I broke out all the signals down here on this terminal strip. One of those signals is remote load on off, and so I'll just connect the signal off of the terminal strip down to the inverter. So I'll just plug that in, and that will turn this on and off. If I want to leave this on and the battery voltage gets too low, the SBMS120 can tell this thing to shut off to keep from discharging the batteries even further. That's the idea, is I want to get this thing working a little bit better in the system. It'll shut off if you get down to about 10.8 volts, I think, is the cutoff. I think it's 10.5 or 10.8, but that's way too low for a lithium battery bank. I need it to shut off at like 12.6 or 12.8 volts. Anyway, I'll keep you updated as I make some progress here on adding my little auxiliary circuit board to control this thing. And if you have any questions, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.